Should you really charge your iPhone using the iPad charger? Will it charge the iPhone faster? And is there any difference between using a cheaper clone charger instead of the original, expensive Apple charger? The truth will be revealed. It is natural to think that if an iPhone safely charges using a smaller charger, then a bigger, more potent charger could be overpowering and cause damage. Actually, this would be true if instead of the standard USB 5 volts, you try, let's say, 12 volts. Don't ever mess with voltage! All USB chargers output 5 volts, or should. Keep watching to the end. The difference between the smaller 5 watts and a bigger 10 or 12 watts brick has to do with delivery capacity. Think of chargers as a juice factory, and right now I am thirsty. This 5-watt factory seems to be just perfect to me. In this example, the charger is able to deliver at the same pace I am able to consume. A 10-watt brick could potentially serve the double of drinks, but I am already consuming as fast as I can, so nothing changes and nothing bad happens. I will continue drinking on my pace. In fact, close to the end, I might even slow down a bit. Now I am fully charged and happy. So, yes, you can use the bigger, more powerful brick to charge your iPhone. Apple assures it is compatible with iPads, iPhones, iPods, including the classic ones, and even compatible with the Apple Watch. When you travel, you can just take one big charger and the cables you need, perfectly safe.
But what about fast charging? I know that the iPhone 6 charges at least twice as fast using the iPad charger.
Well, here on YouTube, I saw videos telling very different stories, ranging from people measuring it would be twice as fast to people measuring it is only 5% faster. So I bought some measuring equipment and I did some real testing on an iPhone 6 Plus, charging from 0 to 100%, taking notes every 10 minutes. You can see the details on the separate video I posted. Basically, what I found is, yes, the iPhone 6 Plus indeed draws more current on a 12-watt charger, but it is not the double nor twice as fast as many people say. In the beginning, it goes much faster. For the initial 70% charge, the bigger brick can do it in almost half the time. Then it slows down considerably. Waiting for a full 100% charged battery, the bigger charger saves you 33% of the time. As I told you before, the maximum charging current is determined by the device. You can't force it beyond. For the iPhone 6, the small 5-watt is less than ideal. The bigger 10-watt brick already provides the best result, and going for 12 watts doesn't make any difference compared to the 10-watt. And for many other devices, like the iPhone 5, the small 5-watt charger is already enough. Now for the final question. I always paid the premium price for original Apple chargers directly from the Apple Store. I know some knockoff clones look identical outside, but I'm not talking about appearances here. I'm asking about electronics. How well do clones perform? Are cheap chargers actually dangerous? Ken Shirriff is a computer scientist very interested in reverse engineering and electronics. He has opened several chargers and made meticulous analysis and comparisons between original Apple chargers and some other well-known brands and obscure clones. Inside, he found that cheaper chargers use much simpler circuits, with some disturbing differences. For example, on all chargers, there is a primary side that handles AC and high voltages, and a secondary part that filters and delivers safe continuous 5 volts to your phone. These two parts should be very well isolated, with at least 3 to 4 millimeters gap. Good brands respect these safety standards, but cheap knockoffs don't. With tiny distances, an electrical surge might jump, passing directly to your phone and fry it. Even if we are lucky and such chargers don't kill us, there is another important difference. Using an oscilloscope, Ken noticed that original Apple chargers deliver very stable voltage, filtering out spikes and frequency noises. But on knockoffs, the voltage is far from stable. Take a look at this one. Can you imagine? Instead of charging your iPhone with constant 5 volts, you would be feeding it with this crazy thing that oscillates from 4.2 to 5.8 volts. Poorly designed chargers will take longer to fully charge your iPhone, and the high frequency noises can cause the touchscreen to malfunction while charging, or even damage the device. If you like electronics, be sure to read Ken Shirriff's blog. He explains everything with great detail and provides extensive footnotes and references. Check the description down below. I will put links to his blog posts and also links if you want to buy the energy meters I used in my tests. To sum up, you can safely use the iPad charger with all your iGadgets. The iPhone 6 charges faster with it, but not twice as fast. With some other devices, it won't make any difference. Cheap chargers can kill you and shorten the lifetime of your iPhone as well. It is a no-no. Give this video a like, subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching. See you on the next video.